Okay, we've got an image called netimg here on our host. Nothing special about it, created from this Docker file here. But we named it netimg as we're going to be using it in this networking module, and a name like that just keeps things nice and simple. Anyway, let's fire up a container from it. And I think we'll call it net1. And we'll base it on our netimg image. And actually, we don't want to be inside the container just yet, so let's drop out. And let's run that bridge control command again. Okay, different. One container spun up, one interface now showing up on the bridge. So that's one attached port to the bridge, right? If we spin up another container, call this one net2, drop out of it again, brctl again. Right, two containers, two interfaces. I think we're starting to get the hang of this now. Now, no rocket science yet, but we have learned that by default, each new container gets one interface automatically attached to the Docker Zero virtual bridge. Great. Now let's jump back into one of those containers. Let's go net1. Okay, so from inside of our container, we can look at our IP addresses. Great. So this is our networking config from inside the container, a loopback address, and a single ETH0. Now note, the ETH0 adapter is on the 172.17 network with a 16-bit subnet mask. Now this is worth knowing. When the Docker daemon starts on our host and it creates the Docker Zero virtual bridge, it assigns it an IP address or a network address as defined in RFC 1918. And we can actually see the Go code here that Docker uses to choose that address. And basically, it tries to pick a network that isn't already in use somewhere else on the network here. Anyway, by default, we should be able to ping the internet. Ping 8.8.8.8. Yeah, there we go. And we can also determine the container's default gateway if we trace route to the internet. So, 172.17.42.1, that's our default gateway, and we'll see this again in a second, but it's the address of our Docker Zero interface on the Docker host. So, let's look at how this ETH0 inside of the container and the VETH interface that we saw connected to the virtual bridge earlier, let's see how they work. And guess what? It's dead simple. Think of them just like two ends of a pipe, with one end in the namespace of the Docker host, and the other end in the namespace of the container. So, ETH0 in the namespace of the container, and then the VETH interface in the namespace of the host. Then, whatever goes into one end of the pipe, pops out at the other end. And it really is pretty much as simple as that. I mean, there's a bit of masquerading and the likes going on that allow outbound packets, but not necessarily inbound packets. But the theory is pretty much like a pipe or a tube. Throw packets in one end, they just pop out of the other end. Or maybe another way to think of it is as a virtual Ethernet cable. One end of the cable is plugged into the ETH0 in the container, and the other end is plugged into the VETH port on the Docker Zero bridge.